Okay, so I took a break and I put on a Raster shirt and I'm ready to wrap this all up. There's one last thing I want to show you from lab this week. So this again is our parking in zones layer that we had made coming out of that raster calculator. And we did something here where we took that and we used a funny or an awkwardly named tool called zonal geometry, which could only be named by an engineer, and you just worry for their kids, what kinds of names they might give their kids. But they gave the name, this tool received the name zonal geometry. And it actually makes perfect sense as to why this is called a zonal tool. And that's part of what I want to kind of talk about today. It has nothing to do with the fact that we're dealing with something, the zones there. But let's get into this. The first time we used it, it was zonal geometry as table. And the reason why I started with showing you the table output is because I thought it might help you get your head wrapped around how this tool works when it's not as a table, but when it actually kicks out a raster. So let's start with what we got here. We asked for it to do this and to, I think, calculate, actually, I think as a table it calculated a bunch of things, but we were particularly interested in area of zones, where zones are identified by a value in the input raster. See where I'm going? Is that so far so good? So the idea is that we had a table that probably had one column called value, and then it had probably a number of things here, but we're particularly interested in is the area measurement. And so one of the values that we would have gotten in the output was zero. And in this case, what it's going to report here is the area that's occupied by the value zero, in the sense that zero is defining a zone where based on the number of pixels that are in that zone. Is that okay? So the idea is that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have 10 pixels or 10 cells times the cell size, which in our case was 30, and then squared, so times, because it's both this and this, right? So times 30 times 30. So I think that's going to give us a 9 with 3 zeros, right, as our area. So that the zone defined by zero, in this case, the zone's all contiguous, doesn't need to be, but the zone is basically all of the cells in the raster that have the value zero. And that zone has an area of 9,000 square meters in this case. So then the value one is not going to appear in our table because one disappeared here. There is no one. It's kind of, not to bring up another matrix thing, but yeah, there is no one, so that gets skipped. So what do you think the area of the zone 2 is going to be? Here's zone 2. So we have 2 cells times 30 times 30 is equal to, is that right? Zone 3? Zone 4? So far so good? So the main idea here is that you have a zonal geometry, because a zone is equal to all cells with a common value. They don't have to, in this place, the cells are all kind of contiguous. They don't even have to be. It's just a zone is going to be defined by all the cells with a common value. And so this is giving you the area of the zone 0, etc. Hopefully that makes sense. And so the other idea, or the other thing, is that we then used this to do just plain old zonal geometry. And this kicked out a raster. Right? And so, what value do you think should go into here? The cell formerly known as 0, right, is going to acquire this value. This guy is also going to acquire that value. So is this one, because it's 0. So what do you think 2 is going to get? What do you think this guy here should get? This one? This guy gets that. So the key thing is that you don't have to do this before you did do this, right? The sequence here is not what I'm trying to kind of teach you, and it's not why I had you do that first. I had you do this first because I thought it might help you get your head wrapped around the concept of a zone, so that when this gets spit out, even though it seems kind of weird that each cell now has the value for this entire zone, that's exactly what is going to happen here. Every cell in the output raster is going to get the area value of the zone of that it's a part of. Is that fair? So that's why this is called zonal geometry. It's also the idea that this tool is part of a family of tools called zonal operations, which differ from local operations, because in zonal operations, the function, the thing that happens, is going to be based on the zone, or all of the cells that share the same value, not on just the location. Right? So in this case, is that fair? And that's the, I think, all I wanted to tell you about this.